Yes, as we wait to the others, you first of all look at that question, see whether they will be able to answer the question. So far, 98 students have joined. Yes, Luis. Luis Kenyo, how are you? Yeah, sorry, unaiona vizuri. Ah. Yeah, so good. Jaribu hiyo swali tukigojea wengine. At least ikifika 11:20, tunaweza endelea, si ndio?
Yes.
Ah, poa poa basi. Yes, those who are still joining, welcome. Happy to notify you that you are 15 minutes late. What I'm sharing there in your screen, I want you to first of all look at the questions, see whether you'll be able to answer. Still waiting for the others. Eh? And when you have a question, you can raise your hand. Eh? Kevin Mureithi, uko na swali? Mureithi, do you have a question? Okay, sawa sawa.
Mwalimu, niko sawa, tuendelee.
Yes, I think that the number is good. I think we can move on. Eh? So we are picking from where we left, and we want to clear this and see whether we'll be able to start another module. That is for arithmetic. That is for a module or document involving calculations from form one up to form four. Meanwhile, I don't know how many of us have been able to get the answers of this question number six. That is where we want to start, okay? Okay, so I've said if you are having a question, you raise your hand, I'll be able to see. So let's look at question number 6A. You're supposed to name the organic compound shown below. So this is the organic compound there. So who have been able to name this compound? Let's see. Anyone? Martin, yes.
Okay, so it's an ester.
Okay, to which class does the compound belong? That is the answer to question part B. That is correct. Eh? Okay. Although the part A was named the organic compound shown below, this one now.
Yeah.
So the ester is not the actual name, but it is the class or the category to which this compound belongs.
Yeah,
yeah. So I need the systematic name of this compound. So far we have known it is an ester. You can raise your hand. I believe you're able to see a point where you can be able to show your hand so that I'll be able to see it. Okay. Who is ready to answer? Anyone? Try to work it out. Alex Ikonya.
The name of the compound is propylbutanoid.
Propylbutanoid. That is correct. So let's see why. Let me try to show you. We have already known that this is an ester. And from our knowledge, we know that esters are formed through a reaction of an alcohol and an alkanoic acid. An alcohol and an alkanoic acid. So when the two react, they form a compound with a general name of alkyl alkanoid. Alkyl alkanoid. Let me try it right here. An alkyl alkanoid. Alkanoate. So the alkyl is from the alcohol part and the alkanoid is the salt from the alkanoic acid. So in this case, how do we identify the alkyl part and the alkanoid part? Normally, when you are given these molecular form or this molecular formula, the alkanoid part normally start. And what will guide you is the functional group of alkanoic acid, which is R, C, double bond O, and then there is an OH there. So this COOH is the functional group of alkanoic acid. So the carbon, double bond oxygen, carbon, oxygen, hydrogen, such that when the reaction takes place, it is at this point from the alkanoic acid, the hydrogen is lost, and that is where a bond will be formed with the alcohol. So that means this carbon here and this oxygen moving backward will form the alkanoid part. Because initially from the formula from of alkanoic acid, the functional group contains a carbon, oxygen, and the OH. But during the reaction, this hydrogen is lost. So that means this oxygen will remain. So in a reaction of, that is a esterification reaction, the alkanoic acid loses the hydrogen in the OH. So that means from here, we can be able to count the number of carbon atoms, and we'll be able to know the number, the parent name of an alkanoic acid that is having 1, 2, 3, 4 carbon atom. An alkanoic having a 4 carbon atom, that is butanoic. So the salt of butanoic is butanoid. Then the alcohol, the functional group of alcohol is ROH. So this R represent the wrong chain, the carbon hydrogen chain, then the functional group. So the functional group of alcohols is this ROH. The functional group is OH. So during a reaction, that is esterification, the OH from the alcohol is lost. That means we are only left with the alkyl part. So the wrong chain part. And that means when the OH is lost, there is that sticky end that will be left representing a single electron from where a covalent bond will be formed. So at this point, so starting from there, going backward, this part forms the alkyl, and we can be able to know from which alcohol this alkyl is. And that according to this, we have three carbons, and that means this alkyl must have contained three carbon atoms. Three carbon containing alcohol is propyl. So we have our name, propyl butanoid. So we start naming with the alcohol, the alkyl part. So the alkyl will be propyl. Then the alkanoid, in this case, the alkanoid is butanoid. I hope everyone is able to understand how an ester is formed. And of course, there is plus water, because where we have this hydrogen from the alkanoic acid and the OH from the alcohol forms water. So the product will be this alkanoid plus water. I can see Nathan, your hand is up. Yes, Nathan.
Yeah, I have a question concerning the part you have said is the alkanoids.
Okay.
I was asking.
Yeah.
Does the Markovnikov's rule apply to this first part?
No. Okay. Normally, in an esterification reaction, yes.
Yes.
There is no use of Markovnikov rule.
Okay.
As the reaction normally takes place where we have the functional group, and in the examples that we normally use, the functional group is at the terminal, yes? So yes. For alkanoic acid, the functional group is at the terminal. And also the alcohol, the functional group is at the terminal, uko mwisho. So, kuna any other ester in as a formula. It's only when the reaction have the compounds having the functional groups at the terminal carbons, okay?
Okay.
Okay, So anyone else with a question concerning a reaction involving esterification? Okay. Okay, so if you have a question, you raise your hand. And then I give you a chance. I unmute you. I unmute you. Okay, maybe after this, I'll give some examples asking you to write equations showing a esterification process, and then you send me in my WhatsApp account number. Okay. We can go to second part. That second part, to which class does the compound belong? I think we had been given the answer to that. That is esters. Esters are formed through a reaction of alcohols and alkanoic acid. As we noted earlier, we can be asked to state the conditions and maybe reagents which may be required in that process. So esterification requires warmth as a condition. And then we also require concentrated sulfuric 6 acid to act as a catalyst for that reaction. So there is two conditions, warmth and a catalyst. So instead of giving the name, the catalyst, we can just say catalyst is a condition that is more acceptable. Moving on, part C, state one use of this compound. So basically uses of esters. Who is willing to give us an answer? Raise your hand, I'll be able to see it. Lee Mwadime.
It's used in the commercial industry in flavoring food and cosmetics.
In food, cosmetics, that is very correct. Any other use apart from in cosmetics? Because we know like when they are producing the sprays, in a marash, actually those are ester compounds. Ile tunanunuanga. Njua wengine wetu wapendi kuoga. Naona mkikuja shule, lazima tusakanye. Kama uko nayo, tunajua huyu mzee hataki kuoga. Okay, so that is one major use. Use in cosmetics. Mm-hmm. and also in additives, food additives. Some of them actually they are natural. They are natural. For example, in bananas, eh? In bananas, that smell of a banana is actually ethyl butanoid. Is a nester. Is a smell of a nester. Ethyl butanoid. Any question regarding on esters? Okay, so let's move on to question number 7, if there is no question on esters. Question number 7 regards polymers. So that the first question is draw the structure of the polymer. So let's read the question. I may give someone a chance to read the question here. Nione kama you will be able to see that question well. Luis, can you take us through question number 7?
Please study the formula of the two monomers below and answer the questions that follow. Number 1, draw the structure of the polymer.
That is correct. We already know what is a polymer. Maybe someone to remind us, what is a polymer? Someone to raise hand, give us the definition of the term polymer so that we start there. Anyone to raise hand and give us the answer? All right, choose. Yeah, and Joshua. What is a polymer? Yes. Unmute yourself. Niona kama watu bado wanasoma ama.
Pardon.
I want us to start by defining the term polymer so that we try to answer this question number 7.
A polymer is a substance comprised of large molecules.
Okay, let's give someone a chance, someone else. Tusikia tatuambia nini. Dennis Musioka.
A polymer, large molecules made by covalently linking many small molecules.
That is okay. That is capturing all the details. Maybe someone with a different answer. Kevin Moravi.
I had the same answer.
Oh, okay, that is correct. So a polymer is a large molecule that is made up of small repeating units referred to as monomers. A large molecule made up of repeating units called monomers. So I had earlier said that polymers can be formed through two methods or two processes. Which are these two processes that I said? Nene kama tunasikiza? Joseph Makau. Yes, Joseph Makau. Yes, Makau, you can unmute yourself. Joseph, are we together? Aha, ni kama tumepoteza huyu. Polymerization process, not esterification, polymerization, yes? Acha tusikie Luis Alvin.
Additional.
There is additional.
Additional condensation. Condensation.
That is very correct. Addition and condensation polymerization. So let's look at this. We are supposed to draw the polymer that is formed when the two monomers combine. First of all, we need to know which are these monomers. And then we need to know which type of polymerization. Can someone identify the name of the first monomer? This one, the first monomer. Hajatuone from Ari Mandime.
Hexane 16-thiol.
Hexane 16.
Dioic
acid. Dioic acid. Hexane 16 dioic acid. That is correct. Maybe we can break it down, see how we have come up with that name. But before that, let's see. The other monomer, what is the name? Lee Mwadime. Okay, wacha tupe mwingine chance. Vincent Mwiti. Vincent Mwiti. Hexane 16 diamine. That is correct. I think first of all, we try to break it, see how we have named this. Okay, I want to try and break this down and see how we have named that. So first of all, we can draw the open structure formula, see how the structure look like. What I can see, I have the first carbon is having double bond. Then there is a carbon and a OH there. So that is a functional group of an alkanoic acid, okay? Then we have in the middle, we have CH2, and I can see there are four of them. So CH2, four of them. 1, 2, 3, and then four there. And then the last one is another, so 1, 2, 3, 4. There is another functional group of an alkanoic acid there. So from this structure, I can see I have two functional groups of alkanoic acid. So that means finally, the parent name will have di. So representing two of them, dioic acid, and we need to know where the two functional groups are, okay? So this is a katikati ni CH2. So kuna hydrogen there, ingine hapo. The CH2s you go up on in. So the total number of carbon atoms, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Hexane 16. So there is this carbon, we start numbering from the terminal carbon. We'll start numbering from this. Because remember, when we are even naming the alkanoic acid, we start by numbering even the carbon that is having, or that is the functional group, okay? So we start there. One, two, three, this is four, five, then six. So we are talking of six carbon alkanoic acid. So that means it is hex. This is hex. Higgs and position 1 and 6, there is the two functional groups. So Higgs, we talk of a dash, then 1, 6. So between the positions, between the positions of the functional group, we use a comma. But between the prefix and the suffix, we use a dash. Okay, and then that means between the position and the suffix now, which is dioic, we use a dash there. So we have our name, that is Higgs 1,6-dioic acid. And then the other one we have, which has been named as hexane 1,6-dioic. In this case, it is a diamine. Hexane 1,6-diamine. So this di, it means two, and in this compound we have two amines group. So this is an amine, and this other one is also an amine. So there are two of them, and they are at carbon number 1 and carbon number 6. Because if you look at the CH2 there are six of them. So we have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. So at this carbon, we have a nitrogen there and two hydrogens. And on the other side, we have a nitrogen and two hydrogens there. So that means position 1 and position 6, we have these two functional groups. It is an amide type of compound. So when the two combines, they form a polymer. And the type of polymer, we are supposed to give the name. And maybe at this point, when hexane 1,6 dioic acid and hexane 1,6-diamine combine, what is the name of the polymer that is formed? Someone? What is the name of the... okay, we have a... I just want to... Brian, come in, you.
Is it nylon 6,6?
That is correct. That is nylon 6,6. So the name is the name of this polyamide polymer is nylon 6,6. That is correct. Okay. I don't know whether someone can try to draw before we go to the next question. Let me try to share a new page. Then someone tries to draw. Wait, give me a second. Someone to raise hand. I hope you are able to see the whiteboard. Calvin Moravi, are you able to see the whiteboard? Calvin Moravi? Brian Kamenju, are you able to see the whiteboard?
Yes.
Are you able to write on it?
I don't think so. I think it's supposed to be you.
Okay, so I'll try to write it here. Everyone, follow this. So we have talked of hexane 1,6. I'm going to start with the hexane 1,6 dioic acid. No, I'm using a mouse, eh? So it is a bit tricky.
Still okay.
So I have this for there. Then you have a C. I have an OH there. And then I have a hydrogen there. So it's a bit. We have the double bond. We have the OH at this point. And of course, on the other side. Okay, that's our hexane 1,6 dioic acid. And then we combine it with hexane 1,6 diamine. We have a nitrogen there. We have hydrogen. We have a hydrogen there. And this is supposed to be a CH2. This is a 6, and then we have an N and a 2 hydrogen there. So this type of polymerization is condensation polymerization. So in this case, it is this dioic acid that will lose the OH, and this is the point where they are going to combine. And then it is the one of the amine that in the terminal carbon that is going to lose the hydrogen. And this will lead to formation of water molecule, because in condensation polymerization, there is loss of small molecules that include water and so forth. So it is at this point they will combine. Now, how do we show that it is a polymer? Note that a polymer, we have said, is a large molecule that contains a repeating monomers. So that means we may have another molecule on this side. That is the dioic on this side. And on this side, we'll have a diamine. So that means on this side, this hydrogen will be lost, so that on the other side, we shall have the dioic. The OH will be lost, and they will combine at that point. But in an exam, when we are giving the answer of a polymer, we only show just a section of that polymer. So at this point, we will not show any other molecule, but we'll leave a dash because we have removed this hydrogen. Because what is supposed to be left there is a bond or a single electron that is supposed to form a bond with another atom. So we leave it at that point. Then on the other side of the dioic, again, it is supposed to lose this OH and join with nitrogen from a diamine, just like at this point. So we have this point and this point. We shall have what we refer to as sticky ends that is supposed to form an extension, so that when we are drawing now that polymer, we shall have what is left there starting from this point. So starting from this point, we shall have carbon, the first one, with its oxygen there. And then we shall have a sticky end, because I've said on the other side we have a diamine molecule that is supposed to lose a hydrogen while this OH is lost, and they will form a bond. But at this point, because we don't want to extend, we just leave that sticky end that is supposed to form a bond. And then continued on this other side. To show that it is a continuation, we use a rectangular bracket and then we make sure that we cut across that sticky end in that manner so that there is an extension of this sticky end. Then the CH2 into bracket 4 in its place. I wish I was having a tablet, it could have been very easy. I'll have drawn that. So from there, this carbon having the oxygen there. And then where we had removed the OH, that electron from this carbon, because you note that this carbon is supposed to have a total of 4 valence electrons. So that means this electron after the oxygen in the toka. Then that is where a bond will be formed with this nitrogen. And then the nitrogen will retain its one hydrogen up there. Don't forget that. And then the CH2 into bracket 6. CH2, then into bracket 6 there. Then there is the nitrogen. And then, as I said, ile hydrogen moja inatoka sababu on the other side kutakuwa na a dioic acid, because those zitakuwa zina alternate. Tukianzia na dioic acid, the next molecule ni diamine. From diamine, dioic. From dioic, diamine, that manner. So this diamine inaruhusi hydrogen, so kuna baki hydrogen moja. So tunayonyesha hapo. And then ikiluzi yo hydrogen kutakuwa na sticky end. So to show that it is a polymer and we have drawn just a section, tunatumia rectangular bracket, we enclose it in that manner. And then to show that it is continuous, because it is a polymer, we normally use an N there in that manner. So this is what we are referring to as nylon. Or nylon 6,6 or just nylon. If you give it as nylon, that is correct. If you give it as nylon 6,6, that is correct. So the reason why we are saying it is nylon 6,6 is because it is made up of two molecule that contains 6 carbon atoms. So 1,6 dioic acid, 1,6 diamine. So that's why you normally say it is nylon 6,6. So, but you can just say it is nylon. That is correct. I hope you are able to follow that. Any question? Any question? I just want to when, Budhia. When do they tuko pamoja?
Yes.
Yo umeelewa?
Yes.
Sawa, sawa. So I want to take you through examples of polymer. Examples of polymer that are formed through addition polymerization, and those that are formed through condensation polymerization, okay? Just wait a bit. Chapter one, are you able to see that? Nataka kusikia from Fortune Wekesa. Are you able to see what I'm sharing in my screen?
Yeah, I can see that.
Ah, good, good. So I was saying I want you to see examples of polymers that are formed through natural polymerization, and there is condensation and addition polymerization. So we were dealing with nylon 6-6 there. Nylon 6-6 is formed through condensation polymerization of hexene 1,6 dioic acid and hexene 1,6 diamine. So don't mind, this is the old name. Eh? That's the old name. So the original name, the recent name that we are using is hexene 1,6 dioic acid. So I've been able to show that process. So let's go back from the starting point, see polymers and examples. And I join you to mess how these are an area whereby you are tested. So I said for addition polymerization, normally takes place in monomers that contains double bond. So long as it contains double bond, so it is not necessarily an alkene, but any other compound that contains a double bond. So long as they are undergoing polymerization, the type of polymerization I've said, it is addition polymerization. So let's see examples of addition polymerization. We have number one, polyethene, the monomers, which are actually the building unit, the repeating units, ethene. So ethene molecules or monomers join to form a large molecule. That molecule will be referred to as a polyethene. So condition high temperature and pressure. In case in a question they ask you the condition which is necessary, high temperatures and pressure, that will be okay. So formation, we had the scenario how the polymer will be formed. We are starting with these ethene molecules. The second step is opening of the bond. The molecule, the double bond open, is one of them. We have two types of bond, a strong one, which is referred to as a sigma bond. Sigma. In a double bond, we have sigma bond, and we have what we refer to as pi bond, pi. There is sigma and pi. So sigma is very strong, so there is much of chemistry there. Pi bond is a weak bond, and it is the one that opens, requires less energy. So what is formed are referred to as free radicals. So from these ethene molecules, several of them, there is formation of free radicals. So there is a free electron there and a free electron there. And that is, of course, that red formation of the pi bond. So from there, the other step is the free radicals joining, forming a long chain. So instead of drawing it in this manner, we shorten it in this manner and use an N there. Okay, so this is the polyethene, or what is referred to as polyethene. But the correct name that you're supposed to give in an exam is polyethene. So uses of polyethene, we had done a question on calculating the number of monomers, where we said it is there to determine the number of monomers. Normally say that the molar mass of the polymer divided by the molar mass of the monomer. So in an exam, you are mostly given the molar mass of the polymer. For example, this one is 4760. So you're supposed to draw the monomer and be able to get the the molar mass of that monomer. So in this case, ethene, that is 28, as it has been calculated. There are two hydrogen and there are four, I mean, there are two carbon and there are four hydrogens. That will give us 28. So 170 ethene. So let's move on. Uses of polyethene, polyethene. There is making of plastic bag, balls, and packaging material. Number two, we have polychloroethene. Polychloroethene, what is the polymer of polychloroethene? So you realize that in all the polymers, the word poly forms the prefix, okay? While the other part is supposed to form now the name of the monomer. So if you get the name of the polymer, they ask you to name the monomer, you only remove the prefix poly. Whatever is left there, that is the name of the monomer. So in this case, the monomer, it is here, it is the chloroethene. So the same process repeat, the double bond opens. Always, the double bond must open such that they will leave two electrons and several monomers will combine at those points. So for example, at this point, those two electrons combine to form a bond there. The same case with this one, they form this other bond there. So we can know the repeating unit there, okay? So finally, after they combine, we shorten that into this format. Then we remember to put an N. So polychloroethene is a monomer that is a polymer that is formed through addition polymerization. So again, the calculation there is just the same. Let's see uses. Polychloroethene, we also note that it is also referred to as polyvinyl chloride, what is referred to as PVC, used in making pipes, very common. Just a minute. Let's move on. Uses making plastic ropes, water pipes, very common, crates and boxes. We have another example of number three, polyphenyl ethene. Polyphenyl ethene, so that means the monomer there is phenyl ethene. A phenyl ethene looks like this, but note that this is the phenyl group, but you can represent it as in this manner. I'm going to show there. This one you can represent it in this manner as a benzene ring. You can represent it as a benzene ring. Benzene ring, we normally show it in this manner. And then a circle at the center. So it can be in this manner or in this manner. I can see Nicholas. Nicholas, you have a question? Nicole, Deuri.
Mwalimu, unaweza kurudisha page nyuma kiasi.
Okay, so that part of
yes.
Parimagani?
Polyethene. Yes, the one before.
Okay, so there is a polyethene ndio ya kwanza.
Apo.
Useme ni wapi?
When chini kiasi chini
sawa utaniambia ni wapi Kwa hiyo hesabu ama wapi?
Nyo kiasi kiasi. Apo, apo.
Sawa, sawa. Let me try to clear this. Okay. Able to follow that? So I was saying, so to just show the part of it, instead of showing several repeating, so these were just examples shown there, how the polymer is formed. But when you are representing it, you just use a section, the repeating unit. So in this case, the repeating unit is containing two carbons, one, two. So at this point, you cut at this point. So that will represent a repeating unit. So on the other side, one, two, you cut another part. One, two, another part, so that the repeating unit contain two carbon atoms. Then the sticky ends must be there. You lengthen them, and these are brackets, only that here it is in the book diagram. You're supposed to enlarge it in that manner. That is okay. Are you okay? Anyone else asking a question at this point? Okay, so I think if you have a question, you post it in my wall, okay? Okay, let's move on. We want polyvinyl chloride. Polyvinyl chloride. Our PVC. We see that the monomers, the name of the monomer is chloroethene. This is the structure. So in an exam, you may be given a structure like this. Let me show you. In an exam, you may be given a structure like this. That's the way it is, without the large rectangular bracket. And then you are asked to draw the open structure of the monomer of the given polymer here. So how are you supposed to extract the monomer? You're supposed to identify the repeating part. So in this case, number one, you can, and in case, you can first of all, you count the number of carbon atoms, then see 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, there are 8 of them. So there's, they can be multiples of, 2 or 4, but then again, carbon number 1, carbon number 2, there is a Cl group there. Moving on, 1, 2, there is a Cl, 1, 2, there is a Cl. So you can notice that after every 2 carbon atoms, there is a Cl group there. So that means the repeating unit, you cut it at this point. Then from there, 1, 2, you cut it such that the two carbons, one of them contains the this functional group. So when you are drawing the monomer, you're supposed to now draw the complete one, because whatever has been removed here, let me draw it well. Let me show you. So that means you only draw the repeating part. That will give you the open structure of the polymer as it is seen down here. So this is what you're supposed to draw as the polymer. And then the monomer, you're supposed to draw the original monomer. So from this, what was the original monomer? So the monomer was chloroethene. You're supposed to ensure that all the carbon atoms have a total of 4 covalent bonds. So these are Cl. And that Cl may be in this carbon or in this carbon. That will be okay in that manner. So this is the monomer. This is the polymer. To ensure that you have the carbon, having a total of 4 covalent bonds. So always note that this sticky end must have been a bond that opened here. So you indicate it there in that manner. So CHAV, so it will be long if you do it in this manner because this will not be correct. Some students have tendency of, I've ever seen this. Hii natachola vizuri, eke hizo hydrogen vizuri, alafu sasa yache hivyo. So this is wrong. You make sure that this double bond is there. Because the molecule, that is the monomer, that is chloroethene, there must be a double bond there. Any question at this point? Okay, so let's continue looking at examples. There is uses. Uses is making of plastic lobes, water pipes, and crates. That is polyvinyl chloride or polychloroethene. Number three, we have polyphenyl ethene. I had said this phenyl group, it is the benzene ring. You attach the benzene ring there. So the polyphenyl ethene, the monomer is phenyl ethene. Aaron Mokau, you have a question? Yes. Okay.
Are you supposed to draw like the one with the double bond ama hiyo yenye iko na?
Yes, hiyo yenye iko na double bond monomer. Yes, the original, eh?
Yes.
Sawa sawa. Aya, so as I said, polyphenyl ethene, the monomer is phenyl ethene. A phenyl ethene, this is the open structure formula. So when there are several of them, they form polyphenyl ethene. And so that's the process. First of all, bond opening, leaving the free electrons. The free electrons will bond with the other free radicals to form a chain. And then finally, this is how the polymer will look like, polyphenyl ethene. So I've said this can be a benzene ring. So you may find it in this manner or a benzene ring. Okay, then there is some same question on calculating the number of monomers. Something else, let's see. Polyphenyl ethene is also referred to as polystyrene. This is also a very common question. In an exam, you are asked to draw the polymer of polystyrene. We are not familiar with polystyrene. But we have seen that that is the other name of polyphenyl ethene. So polystyrene or polyphenyl ethene. Uses, very common, you may be asked to state the uses, but note there are those uses which are common in these polymers. We have sealing tiles, cloth lining, making of packaging material for carrying a delicate item like computers, radions, and calculators. Number four, we have polypropene. Polypropene, the monomer is propene. How do we draw the structure of propene? The usual propene, but the way we are putting it here, note that this is 1, 2, 3, a very carbon containing alkene. You have a double bond there, polypropene. So why we put it there, why we are putting it here and not the usual place that we know, we extend the upper, is because we want to show that when this bond open, there is an electron that is left there. And we are able to show there is an extension on this side and there is an extension on that side. Eh? So we shift it. Instead of placing it here as the CH3, we would expect it to be a CH3 there. Instead of putting it there, we shift it in this at that point, okay? So this will help us when we open this bond, we'll be able to show an electron there and an electron there. So as it is seen in this step number two here, in step number two, that is opening of the pi bond. So in this manner. So naona kama hii ingekuwa hapa, then hatungeweza kuplace hii vizuri. So the aim of being this is to ensure tumeonyesha this ending. This sticky end. What I'm calling sticky end is where we have this electron forming an extension on that side, an extension on that side. So that finally, the polymer will be represented in this manner. So you shift that CH3, the terminal carbon in this carbon number two downward, okay? Or upward, that can also be okay. So what is important is to identify where the double bond is. So if you have indicated it it is in carbon number one, then the other part, carbon number one, carbon number two, if it does not share that double bond, then hiyo mkia ingine yote yenye iko huko unai shift chini, so that you'll be able to show that sticky end on that side, this side and on this side, okay? If you have a question you ask, eh? I'll stop and explain mahali ujaelewa. So that means free radicals in a formula. From there, free radicals collide with each other. So that's why we need high pressure for them to collide. Then, finally, this is what will be formed. Polypropene. You can draw that. Polypropene. So the monomer, I've said it is. The monomer is propene. So in this case, if they ask you to draw the open structure of propene, you just draw the normal one, eh? In this manner. So hapo kuna hydrogen, hapo kuna hydrogen, hapo kuna carbon, ya pili, then ya tatu. Ile tu ya kawaida, eh? Ile chain, ile open structure formula ya the chain. In that manner. I hope you are able to see that. Kuandika na mouse, it is challenging. But I hope you are able to see that. Eh? So mtu anaweza chola hii. That is okay. they ask you to draw the open structure of the monomer of polypropene. That is correct. So unaona ikiwa hivi, kuonyesha hii structure inaweza kuwa a challenge. Wezi onyesha inaweza kushinda kuonyesha hii. So that's why I was saying anything from the carbon number two, if for example number one, number two and the carbon that are sharing the double bond, hiyo ingine iko huko nyuma, you shift it kwa hiyo carbon number two iende chini. Sasa ikienda chini kama hapa ama kama hii ya kwanza, naona hii ya kwanza, hii mkia iko chini, lakini pia ukichola hivi you have condensed part of it. Hii haitakuwa open structure formula sababu ume condense hii, but it is still correct if you draw it as a monomer, so long as they asked you to draw the monomer, you can show it in this manner, that is okay. Hakuna mtu atakunyima mark, but this is more correct, this one, eh? Mm. So that means when you are to show the monomer, the polymer, sorry, anything yenye iko after the second carbon that is containing the double bond, we shift chini so that you will be able to show this sticky end. Otherwise, itakuwa challenge. Wezi yekea, acha tuone. For example, what I was saying is that inaweza kuwa shida sana. For example, wezi yekea hiyo that rectangular bracket uko, that one will be wrong. Sasa, so hapa ndio tunataka hapa. So hii carbon na hii, hiyo ingine yenye inafuata huko inafaa kuwa unaiteremusha huku. So CH3, you condense it in that manner. That is correct kama hii sasa. So I think that way you'll never ever have any challenge when you are showing addition polymerization type of polymers, okay? Any question? Naona tumebakisha 4 minutes, eh? Maybe first of all, we look at the other remaining two of polymers that are formed through addition polymerization. Then hizo zingine, I will look at them in the next lesson, okay? So the same type of question on calculation still repeats, eh? Okay, so the other type of polymer that is formed through addition polymerization is polytetrafluoroethene. The monomer is tetrafluoroethene. The monomer tetrafluoroethene unaichora hivi. So several of them, the second step is opening of the double bond. We have free radicals formed at the high pressure and temperature. They collide to form a wrong chain molecule. In this wrong chain molecule, uko mwisho unacha a dash, eh? That sticky end, whereby ukichola sasa the repeating unit moja ni yako tu tetrafluoroethene, unakachora hivyo, okay? Okay. Let's see the uses of this polytetrafluoroethene. The monomer is tetrafluoroethene. The polymer, you represent it in that manner. The same type of question, you'll never miss that. Another important thing is polytetrafluoroethene is referred to. Again, in a question, you can be asked to draw the polymer of Teflon. So if you don't have an idea what a Teflon is, na hiyo lakini tumesoma, you may end up failing, okay? So the other name of polytetrafluoroethene is Teflon, abbreviated as PT FE. Again, you can get this abbreviation. You are supposed to draw that. So in an exam, if they ask you to name the polymer, for example, they have drawn this polymer in an exam, they ask you to name, you can give either of the name Teflon or polytetrafluoroethane. Both of them will be correct. Uses. First of all, it is a tough, non-transparent, and durable plastic. So at this point, I think it is showing that it is familiar to PVC, okay? It's familiar to PVC. I think that is what is supposed to be meaning, okay? Let's look at uses making ropes, water pipes, box, and crates, similar to PVC. Okay, so the last type of polymer that is formed through addition polymerization is latex. Latex is a rubber that is formed from latex. We have natural rubber, and we have synthetic one. So at this point, now that time is up, I want you to go and learn more on the two types of rubber, the natural one and the artificial. You get the name of the monomers, okay? Then you draw the open structures of the monomers, as well as the polymer itself for the two of them. Remember, in rubber, there is something we refer to as vulcanization of rubber. Anyone remembering what we learned in school? What is a polymerization of rubber? Sorry, vulcanization of rubber? Yes, nataka tufungia hapo. Polymerization of rubber. Sorry, vulcanization of rubber. Louise. Louise Alvin.
Hardening of rubber.
Hardening of rubber. That is correct. Acha tuone Austin Njora. Tumeambiwa that vulcanization is hardening of rubber. How is it carried out? Austin Njora. Tuko pamoja. Njora, Austin, how is it carried out? You can unmute yourself. Okay, so ni kama Njora. Aja tusikie from Joseph Makau. Ina involve nini hardening of rubber? Joseph, uwanja ni wako.
Addition of sulfur.
Addition of sulfur. Any other process that is involved in the addition of sulfur? Okay, we normally say, we heat a mixture of rubber and sulfur at low temperatures, okay?
Yes.
So part of the addition of the assignment, apart from drawing the monomers and the polymer, I want you to, using equation, show the process of vulcanization of rubber, okay? Yeah, I think from to this point, mpaka hiyo lesson ingine yenye ni ya Friday. So I think the first thing ni kuona kama uliweza kufanya hiyo, so that someone will be able to show us that equation, how vulcanization is achieved, okay? Hai, sawa, basi, good, my lesson is over. See you on Friday. Be on time, okay? Thank you for participating. May God bless you. Take care. Wash your hands. Keep social distance, okay?
Thank you.
Yes, awesome.
Mm-hmm.
Sibangal.
Sasa ni wakati.
Shosho, lista.
Pakji kuna kuna.
Ati shosho distance.